World Bank, Mr. Zunaid Kamal Ahmed, Home Secretary, Mr. Rajiv Gauba, and Secretary MEA, Ms. Preeti Sharan, Member of the National Disaster Management Authority, Mr. R.K. Zain, and Mr. Kamal Kishore, Member NDMA, distinguished participants from different countries, representatives of central and state governments, colleagues from the private sectors, friends from media, ladies and gentlemen, I warmly welcome you all to New Delhi for this important workshop on disaster resilient infrastructure. A little more than 1 year ago, we hosted the Asian Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction in New Delhi. At that conference, our Prime Minister outlined a 10-point agenda to give a sense of urgency to the implementation of Sendai framework for disaster risk reduction. His first point emphasized the need for investing in infrastructure in a manner so that it can withstand hazards not only now but also in the future. He called for establishment of a coalition that would bring together key partner countries and stakeholders to work on disaster resilient infrastructure. Since the AMCDRR, we have been pursuing this theme consistently. Infrastructure has saved human civilization for millennia. Our forefathers showed tremendous foresight when they developed infrastructure that served us for generations. Whether it is the drainage system of Harappan civilization, or the aqueducts of the Roman Empire, or in more recent countries, the system of interconnected lakes in the city of Udaipur in India, they are all awe-inspiring works of human endeavor. They have helped us tame the fury of nature while also helping us maximize the benefits of Mother Nature's benevolence. We often take our infrastructure system for granted. After all, infra means something that stays under the main structure and almost out of sight. Over the last two centuries, development of infrastructure has unleashed the human potential in unprecedented ways. Countries that have invested in infrastructure have created opportunities for their people to not only come out of poverty but also to flourish. It is now widely recognized that in the coming decades, robust infrastructure will be at the core of sustainable development, and this is also recognized in the way the sustainable development goals have been framed. Ladies and gentlemen, there are several expressions that are used in the international discourse to describe the unprecedented infrastructure growth that will take place in the coming decades. Some of these include the infrastructure that we will build in the next 20 years will be more than what we built over the last 2000 years. More than 70% of the infrastructure that our cities will have by 2050 is yet to be built, and so on. The specific estimates themselves are even more mind-boggling, and at the level and the global level, by 2040, to adequately meet the infrastructure needs of humanity, we will need nearly $100 trillion. By 2030, Asia alone will need $26 trillion in infrastructure investment. Regardless of which numbers we focus on, the challenges and the opportunity at the national, regional and global levels are enormous. Infrastructure systems, by definition, are built for the long term to serve many generations. The way we build our infrastructure today will either build risk or resilience for the future generations. We need to bring to bear tremendous foresight and rigor to ensure that all our new infrastructure is built to withstand the hazards of the present as well as the future. Our generation shoulders enormous responsibility for getting this right. Ladies and gentlemen, the infrastructure system of the 21st century are unprecedented, not only in terms of the scale, but also in terms of their interconnectedness. And disruption in infrastructure in one part of the world can disrupt global supply chains and cause havoc in a manner that is hard to predict and harder still to quantify. Add to this the challenge of climate change. Climate-related extremes are likely to become more intense and frequent. Past is no longer a good guide for the future. For example, in our own country, we are observing that floods are taking place in areas that are traditionally not known to be flood-prone. There are parts of the country that are experiencing heavy rainfall and floods, in spite of the fact that overall seasonal rainfall is below normal. These changes will pose new challenges for how we design our infrastructure for the future. In this regard, both the developed and the developing countries are in the same boat. Ladies and gentlemen, while we face unprecedented challenges, we also have unparalleled opportunities also. The advances in geospatial technology, computing capabilities, advances in artificial intelligence promise us a future where we will be able to make most optimal use of our resources. These capabilities will form the design, construction, operation and maintenance of infrastructure system. This promise will be fully realized only if we are able to connect these capabilities to our social and economic realities. The challenges of building disaster resilient infrastructure is such that no country can address it alone. This is a common challenge where countries from the south and the north, small island countries and the landlocked countries, small economies and large economies, countries with century-old infrastructure system and countries at the nascent phase of infrastructure development need to come together and devise strategies for securing our common future. We are pleased to host this conversation among representatives from government institutions, experts from technical institutions and the academia, and international organizations, multilateral development banks and the private sector. Each one of you in this hall has an important role to play in building a resilient future for the humanity. On behalf of the Government of India, I would like to assure you that this event is only a first step in this common journey. Over time, we will engage this conversation with other countries and stakeholders and work closely with all of you in generating ideas and implementing them. I wish you a very fruitful workshop. I hope, despite your busy schedule, over the next 2 days, you will have the opportunity to explore the historic city of Delhi and its surroundings. Thank you very much.